Hi students, how are you? In our last class, real numbers, we already successfully completed. Everyone should do those all problems. If you have any doubt, you can contact me. Now we are start the new topic, that is polynomials. Before going to the polynomials and factorization, we can know some constants, variable terms, and polynomial definitions. What is the constant? Constant is a fixed value. It is denoted by a, b, c. And are constant numbers. That value is fixed at anywhere. Now we are going to the variable. What is the variable? It denotes by a symbols x, y, z like that. That value that can take any real value. X value can take any value, any real value. Now term. Term is either a single number, either numbers or symbol. That means variables or the combination of numbers and variables. That means numbers and variables multiplied together. Numbers and variables. Numbers and variables multiplied together. That means either 1 or 2 or x or y or multiplied 2x or 3y. These all are called the terms. This is called the term. Term is either a single number or variable or numbers and variables multiplied together. This is called a term. Terms means not only one term. Now you have to take like this 2x plus 3y. Now in this case we have two terms. Now we can take 2x plus 3y plus 4z. Now in this case we have three terms. Like that. Now we are going to the third one, polynomial. What is the polynomial? We know an algebraic expression. Algebraic expression means containing the variables and constants. That means the volume formula LBH. Volume formula is LBH. Is called the one algebraic expression. Now x square plus 2xy plus y square is also an algebraic expression. Now I am taking this type of algebraic expression with an algebraic expression contains non-negative integral powers, either 0 or positive. Non-negative, either positive or 0. Non-negative integral powers is called polynomial. Every algebraic expression is need not to be a polynomial, but every polynomial is a algebraic expression. An algebraic expression contains non-negative integral power. This is very important. Non-negative integral power is called polynomial. Now we are taking some polynomials like x square plus y plus z square. Is it polynomial? Once check it. Non-negative integral powers. Once observe here powers 2, 1, 2. These are positive numbers. Now these are non-negative numbers. Then it is an polynomial. It is a polynomial. Now I am taking 5. The number 5. Constant number. Now is it polynomial? What is the polynomial? Every composite number can be expressed as a product, an algebraic expression containing non-negative integral powers. Non-negative. If you observe 5, 5 can be written as 5 into x to the power of 0. 0 is a power, 0 is a non-negative integral power. Therefore, 5 is also a polynomial. Now I am taking one more. 1 by 2. X square. 1 by 2 x square. Non-negative integral power. Integral power. If you observe the power, it is 2. It is non-negative integral. Then it is also a polynomial. Now I am taking root x. Root x can be written as x to the power of 1 by 2. Is it polynomial? Root x is a polynomial? No, it is not a polynomial. Why? The polynomial definition is an algebraic expression containing non-negative integral. If you observe here, it is a rational number, not integer. Therefore, it is not a polynomial, but it is a algebraic expression. Okay, that's why we are saying every polynomial is a algebraic expression, but every algebraic expression need not be a polynomial. Now we are going to the coefficients and degrees. Coefficient, what is the coefficient? For example, I am taking 2x square plus 5x plus 7. In this case, what is the coefficient of x? What is the coefficient of x? If you take x in this term, 5 is the coefficient of x. 5 is the coefficient of x. Coefficient of x square is 2. 2 is the coefficient of x square. Now what about 7? 7 is the constant. 7 is the constant. 5 is the coefficient of x. 2 is the coefficient of x square. Now I am taking one more number. 3x cube plus 7xy plus 4z square. Now in this polynomial, this is a polynomial because non-negative integral power. Now in this polynomial, what is the coefficient of y? If you want y coefficient, 7x. 7x is the coefficient of y. What is the coefficient of x cube? 3. 3 is the coefficient of x cube. 4 is the coefficient of z square. 4 is the coefficient of z square. 7x is the coefficient of y. 7 is the coefficient of xy. 3 is the coefficient of x cube. This is about the coefficient. Now we are going to the degree. What is the degree? Degree means highest power of a term. If you take this polynomial, in this polynomial I am taking this is a term. And it is a term. And it is a term. Totally 3 terms are there. Now I am taking this term. What is the degree highest power? 3. Now what is the degree here? 2. 1 plus 1. 2. Here 2. Now what is the highest value in this? 3. Now the total polynomial degree is 3. If you take a monomial, first we have to find the every monomial degree. In this degree, in these powers, which is highest power, that is the degree of the given polynomial. First we have to find the every monomial degree and then apply for the whole polynomial. Now if you take this one, what is the this monomial degree? 2. Here it is 1. Here it is 2. Now what is the highest degree in these 3? 2. Now the degree of the x square plus y plus z square polynomial is 2. Now once say this one. Now here 3 terms, 1, it is 2. In this case it is 1, it is constant, it is 0. Now highest power is 2. Now in this polynomial degree is 2. Like this you have to find that degree. Now, yeah, based on degree, we have to divide the types. Now, zero polynomial degree we cannot find, but that zero polynomial can be written like this. 0 into x cube plus 0 into x square plus 0 into x plus 0. That means if a polynomial having all the coefficients are equal to 0, then the polynomial name is zero polynomial. Once again I will repeat. All the coefficients in a polynomial are 0. In a polynomial, all the coefficients are equal to 0, then the polynomial name is zero polynomial. Now based on degree, if the degree is 0, then the polynomial name is 0, if the degree is 0, then the polynomial name is constant polynomial. Constant polynomial. Like 1, 2, 3, these numbers. Now, if the degree is 1, then the polynomial name is linear polynomial. If the degree is 1, then the polynomial name is linear. For example, 2x plus 7y plus 3z. If you observe this degree is 1 or 5y, like this. Now, if the degree is 2, then the polynomial name is quadratic polynomial. If the degree is 2, quadratic polynomial. Now you can take some examples for the quadratic polynomial. X square plus 2x plus y, just 2x square, or 7x square plus 2xy plus 5, like this. If the degree is 2, quadratic, like this. If the degree is 3, cubic polynomial, cubic polynomial. And if the degree is 4, biquadratic polynomial. This is the types of the polynomial based on degree. Now we are going to based on terms. Based on terms, the types of polynomials. First, if the number of terms is 1, only one term, then the polynomial name is monomial. Monomial. If the number of terms is 1, monomial. Example, 2x, 7x cube, 9x cube plus 9x square, and so on. Only one term, then the name is monomial. If the number of terms is 2, binomial. If the number of terms are 2, then the name of polynomial is binomial. Example, 2x plus 3y, 7x square plus 2, 5x cube plus 7, etc. These are the types of the polynomial for the binomial. If the degree is 3, trinomial, and so on. These are the types of the polynomials based on terms. These are the terms of the polynomial based on degree. Now, everyone should do these once, practice these types and do the exercise 1 and do these, try these problems.